Today I have with me a gentleman that I met while I was studying presentations within the institutions. And Carlos Christian, this is Carlos to my right. He's going to actually come to you before I start to speak to you. Carlos is a now published author of the book Prison Without Bars. He is the president and founder of the Starts Within organization, which is a fatherhood group. And he is a committed dad. But before Carlos comes, we're going to have Susan stand up to kind of just give you her experience with Carlos with dealing with him and his fatherhood group.
Good morning. For those of you who don't know me, probably a lot of you do because I've done the tour of Ohio in my career in child support, starting in Lawrence County, Athens, Delaware, now Franklin. So anyway, I've been in the program for 18 years, a long time, in various different counties. I wanted to take a minute this morning because there are some people in some programs that are worth mentioning and really mentioning as being special. And the Starts Within program is a program that has really touched my heart. I've met Carlos actually a couple of years ago. We have two major fatherhood programs in Franklin County in Columbus. One is the father-to-father program through the Columbus Urban League, and the other is Father Factor through Action for Children. And I actually met Carlos at a fundraising event with Action for Children. And his story resonated with me from the first time I met him. And I think he's, I don't want to steal any of his thunder, but he'll tell you his story. But what's most impressive to me about Carlos is that he has an innate ability to motivate people. And he has an innate ability to especially motivate fathers who have barriers, obstacles, and have been incarcerated. As a matter of fact, I most recently went to one of his graduations in Marion State Correctional. The Walking Logo program. And he took a group of 10 guys through a 12-month program. Once a week program for 12 months. And they couldn't be late, and they had to attend every class. And if they were late, they did push-ups for every minute that they were late. So I don't know if they were late enough or a lot, but these guys were really big guys. but anyway, what was incredible was that they each had their own story. And these guys were hard. I mean, they were hardened guys when they went into prison. And Carlos transformed these guys into, really, I mean, the one guy who was a valedictorian, he could have been a Presbyterian minister, you know, and he was a gang member whose vocabulary was, I don't know, profanity 101. It's just the way that he transformed those guys was just incredible. And they gave their testimonials, and the whole time, Tiffany was there too. The whole time they were giving their testimonials, I had to bite my tongue, back because I just wanted to fall. I mean, it just brought out so much emotion in you. And because of the transformation that you were seeing before your eyes. And so anyway, I was really good through the whole graduation until Carlos came up to me at the end and gave me a hug and then the floodgates opened. but it's that ability to change lives is why I'm standing up here today, you know, just basically, having Carlos, because he's just the real deal. And he did write a book, and I read it. It's called Prison Without Bars. And it's a primer for gentlemen who are in prison, how to make the best use of their time while they're in prison, gain education, gain skills, gain a new outlook on life while they're in prison, so that when they come out, they can be successful. And the reason why Carlos is so credible is because he walks the walk and talks the talk, because he's been there, he's done it. And he'll tell you that story. And, you know, in his best shining moment is sitting back in the back of the room, and that's Carlos Jr., Los Jr., who Carlos established a relationship with while he was in prison, and he was in prison for 10 years. And he established a relationship with his son, and his son now is has graduated high school and looking at college, right? And very, very successful. So, with that, Carlos Christian.
How's everybody doing this morning? Well, I'm Carlos Christian. When I say we're the father that starts within an organization, what we do is we work with individuals who are currently incarcerated for 52 weeks. We work with those same group of individuals for 52 weeks after they get released as well. Our mission is to reduce the recidivism rate, and we get that done through education and mentoring, right? So, and I'm also a committed father. I have a 7-year-old. I have the 18-year-old there, Lil Los. That's what I call him, Lil Los. And also, I have a stepson, Devin, too, as well. And he's 17, so I'm a busy man, and it's good to be busy nowadays. And I'm just excited for the opportunity to be able to present to you guys about what Starts Within is about, and about my story too as well. So I'm gonna give you a peek into my life for a bit, and just take up a little bit of your time. And I'm gonna start back when I was 13 years old. I had started to sell drugs. When I was 13 years old, I had information coming from rappers and the environment that I was in, and it was saying that if I sell drugs, I was going to be able to be the successful businessman, and I was going to be able to be a Cayman Island somewhere, and the Bahamas, I was going to be able to live like Brand, right? But that didn't happen. Actually, I was 19 years old. I had a 3-month-old. I was a proud father, and I said that I was going to turn it up another notch so my son can experience the Cosbys, and that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to create a life like the Cosbys, and I was going to get it accomplished by selling drugs, and it didn't happen. So 3 months later, I had ended up getting caught up in my transactions, and I had to go away and do 10 years in prison. Now, when I did the 10 years, I said, hold up. When I was sitting on my bed, I said, this is not the Bahamas and this is not the Cayman Islands. This is like next door to hell, close to death. This isn't what the rappers were talking about when they were telling me that sell all the drugs that you can sell and you'll be able to obtain this. It wasn't that reality that I was trying to create. So I made the decision when I was 19 years old inside of my prison cell, and I had my 3-month-old, and I said that I was going to be dedicated to be a committed father. I don't care about me being in prison. I don't care about my current reality. I was going to create a new reality, and I was going to start within. I said that I was going to start within myself, and I was going to start within my current situation. I said, I'm not going to let my circumstances define me. I am going to define my circumstances. So I started to be obsessed with improvement. So I said that I got to be better than I was yesterday, today, and then tomorrow I'm going to be better than I was today. So I just was obsessed with improvement, and I said, I'm going to do everything that I need to do to be a better individual so I can impact my son's life so he don't make the same mistakes that I have made because of the decisions that I had made. So I said, I'm going to improve myself and redesign myself. And what you see with the logo, you see that the logo, you see the guy on the left-hand side. I know it's kind of difficult for people to see, but I'm going to describe it. The guy on the left-hand side of the Starts Within organization's logo, he's a liability in the community. He has a number on his chest. It's 355519. You transfer that to the guy on the right-hand side, who has his family in the background. He's in a suit and he looks okay, and he's content, and life is good. He's living like the way that he desires to live life, and this is what it's about. But I made that transformation when I was inside. See, what starts within talks about, it says that you got to become who you need to become before you get released from prison, meaning that I can't wait to be a dad when I get home. I got to start being a dad right now. That means that I started to be a dad while I was in prison, meaning that when you look at me, you seen dad. It was no mistake, and that means that everybody inside of prison, they knew that Carlos Christian was a father, and they knew Little Lowe's. Everybody knew Little Lowe's because I made sure that I wrote him once a week, all capital letters, and skip lines, and made sure that I wrote that letter once a week. I blocked out a period of time to make sure that that letter got home to my son. I went to the commissary. Commissary is the store inside of the prison. I went to the commissary, and I went there to buy candy. That means that I would get $20 a week from my father, and I would take that money. Some on special occasions, I would take that money and I would buy $15 worth of Skittles, $15 worth of Snickers, $15 worth of Kit Kats, and I would put it home. I would put it in a box, send it home to my son with a letter and a card saying, "Here you go, son. Dad is here. Daddy's cool as cat." This is critical things that has to be done while you are incarcerated to be able to establish a relationship with your son. And that's what I said, is that I will not stop being a dad. I'm dedicated. See, I wanted to be a dad bad. And anything that you want to be bad enough, you will be. And that's what I wanted to be, and that's what I became. I became a good father while I was in prison. So then when I came home, I was able to fall right in line and do what I needed to do. Graduated from Marion Technical College with a 3.83 GPA inside of prison for business management. I went to administrative office technology as well, vocational training, information. Thinking controls behavior, information influences thinking, meaning that I need some new information to influence my thinking so I can start to behave in a different manner. I don't want to behave like an outlaw no more because I don't like the outlaw benefits. I want to behave like a civilian because I am just infatuated with the civilian benefits. They get to unlock their own doors. They get to see their children raised. They get to eat Jell-O with the fruit in it when they want to. That's my thing. That's what I like to do. I like to eat Jell-O with the fruit in it. And I also like to watch the Browns game when I want to watch the Browns game. I want to watch the Cavs game when I want to watch the Cavs game. I like to be around positive people. I don't want to be around a whole bunch of people with mean faces and everything is hard. Everything is hard. The water is hard. The people in there is hard. The band is hard. I need to change my environment, and I did it while I was incarcerated. Starts Within says, don't wait until change comes. You go out there and make change. You make change. And that's what I did. I made change. I made change. Information, information, information. I needed new information to saturate my mind with so I could start to become a new individual, because it was imperative that I be that new individual for my son, not to experience the same things that I experienced.
Okay, they turned it down. They turned it down. I'm about to get hyped now.
Hello? Hello? Okay, there we go. So, okay, cool, cool, okay. Okay, yes. So I didn't want my son to experience the same thing that I experienced, because I said that prison was hell. Remember, I came to that realization that prison was next door to hell, and that it was close to death. And I said that, you know what, when I found out about prison, I started to get information. And this is what I'm able to do now, so this starts with their organization, is give these guys the information. One thing about prison is that I started to do some research, and I realized that the only way that I can be a slave in the United States of America is if I get convicted of a crime. And I said, no, it's not like slavery, it is actually slavery. But now you have to choose to be a slave in the United States of America. 13th Amendment, neither slavery nor involuntary servitude, except for as punishment for a crime, where if the punishment is duly convicted shall exist in the United States or any other place subject to his jurisdiction, except for as punishment for a crime whereof the party shall have been duly convicted. That's the only way you can be a slave in the United States. So then that's why I get paid 22 cents an hour while I'm incarcerated. That's why the furniture factory can make $50 million a year and pay me 22 cents and then give me a 3 cent raise after I worked there for 3 years, because I'm a legal slave, because I chose to be a slave. This is the information that I'm giving the guys inside of prison to start to change the way that they are thinking, so they can control their behavior, so that they are not outlaws, so that they are not outlaws and having outlaws mentalities. Because now they are saying, you know what, I don't want my son to experience that same thing. I don't want my daughter to experience that same thing. So what do I need to do? I say that you cannot give your children direction if you do not have direction. It doesn't make sense. That means that if I go home and I'm this guy that's then that's when my children will follow. And if my children go through the same thing that I'm going through today, 10 years from now, it's going to be worse, because things that happen at a later time, the same thing, it only gets worse as time goes on. I was committed to being a father. When I came home, I said, wow, I'm gonna go ahead and get a minimum wage job. I worked it like it was $40 an hour. I had a $6.85 hour job. I worked like it was $40 an hour. Because I said, I'm just not going back to prison. Anything that says prison, I'm not going, and I'm not going to make that decision to do it. So I know that by me working a job, it wasn't going to put me back in prison, and I was going to be able to take care of my son and raise my son, my responsibility. That's the greatest responsibility that an adult will have in his life, the development of an actual individual. He's a one-on-one. I'm a one-on-one. That means that my left side is different from my right side. That means that all of the fingerprints on my hands are different. Nobody has been created like me before me. Nobody will be created like me after me. I am a one-on-one. Anything that is a one-on-one got to be valuable. That means that I have not been duplicated. See, the reason why people live the lives that they live is because they don't understand their true value, because their value has been beaten down by society. But everybody is valuable. Everybody has value. Nobody has ever had your DNA, and nobody ever will. I don't care if you have a twin. They will not have your same exact DNA. That means that you are a one of one. You can duplicate cars. You can duplicate materialistic things. You can duplicate money. You can do all of that, but you cannot duplicate an actual individual. That means that a bump under the bridge under a cardboard box is valuable, because that bump is a one of one. Information influences thinking. Thinking controls behavior. This is the information that people need. Now, when Tiffany comes into the prisons and she partnered with Starts Within, and Starts Within, what we do, we cover five different areas. We cover parenting, cognitive behavior therapy, financial literacy, employment readiness, and small business and entrepreneurship. We cover these different areas so these guys can have the right information and the right skills so that they can transition back into society. Also, the other information that they have is that they are valuable and they can become something greater than where they are currently at. And I showed them that by presenting them me. I did 10 years. I've been home for over 8 years. I got released right in 2007, 2 months before the Great Recession. I've been able to establish myself. I've been able to get custody of my son, raise him. Instead of him going to prison, Carlos is going to Columbus State Community College and transfer that to Ohio State for Business Management. Carlos is here. That's the thing. That's what I'm saying. Okay. That's cool stuff. Because Carlos, this is how people often say, man, how do you reduce mass incarceration? You reduce mass incarceration by reducing the recidivism rate, meaning that because I found direction, now my son will not go down the same path that I went down. So he's not even going to get incarcerated, because I made the decision not to go back. That's how we attack mass incarceration. That's exciting now. Not who I was. He's not emulating the outlaw mentality. He's emulating the civilian who's making decisions, looking at all of the pieces of the puzzle before I make a decision. And if I don't have the right information, then I will not make a decision. My decision is to not make a decision. He's emulating that guy. He's already focused on his credit. At 18. Motivation. Why are people not motivated? Because they have no direction. If you give them direction, they will be motivated. Lack of direction is why people are not motivated. So now we give them the information. When I came home, I didn't know how child support worked. I thought that because I came home and I was getting my son and I was taking care of him and me and his mom was on good terms, I thought that everything was cool. I thought that they was going to find out where I worked at and take the money straight out of my checking account. They did not do that. I didn't know that I had to go to child support to check in. I said I didn't check in when I was in the penitentiary. They was taking it out of my state pay. I thought they were going to do the same thing when I went home. They didn't. They sent the letter to my old address where I was at a halfway house at. I didn't get it. When I realized what was going on was when I was getting pulled over and they said that my license is gone. I said, hold on. I got to get my son to football practice today. Got on the phone, called child support. I say, listen, hey, got the wrong guy. I'm a good dad. They said, you haven't been making your payments. We sent a letter to your place of residence. You have to update your information with child support. You have to let child support know where you are at. You have to communicate with child support. If you communicate with child support, you won't have these issues. So you know what I did. I put child support in my Fade 5. That was Fade 5 back then, for T-Mobile. I put it in my Fade 5 because I was talking to child support so much that I didn't want to burn up my minutes on my minute plan. So I said, I'm going to put y'all in my Fade 5. So y'all information that I needed, because once I got that information, you think that I'm going to just ask to get my license suspended? You think that I'm going to laugh, ask and go back into jail? You think I'm a, oh, they like my bank account too. I say, wow, I was charging things like buying a pack of gum and I was going over it because they was like, I say, that's a $35 pack of gum. Information. So, with that being said, ended up getting things squared away with child support after a couple of years. I had got custody of Carlos and child support was no longer existing. But when it was, I was okay because I understood what needed to be done. A lot of times, people don't have the information. People don't have the information on how to be a good parent. People don't have the information on how to be a good dad. People don't have the information on how to be a good person. If they don't have that information, they're going to behave from the information that they have. It is critical that we give these guys the information. Education is key. That's why you see me here today. And I am just so intent and excited to duplicate my story. I'm not nobody special. My organs are the same as everybody else's organs. I have organs inside of me. There's nothing special about me. It's just that I have gotten the information. I have put myself around individuals who's going to give me the information. That's the only difference. So we can duplicate this story 1,000 times 1,000 times 1,000 until we have fathers inside of the households raising their children, so then their children is not a liability in the community, and their children are assets in the community, so then the fathers are no longer liabilities in the community, and the fathers are assets in the community. I tell the fathers now, I'm not against child support, because sometimes people, they don't pay for stuff. Fathers have had the rap to say, I'm going to party and forget that I have a child. I understand the reason behind child support. Because they have good intentions, but after the week is over, they have spent all of their money and they haven't set nothing aside for their children. I know that everybody isn't as committed, and the ones who aren't committed is being set up in place for those individuals. So when I go inside of the prisons, I don't sit up here and say, we're gonna find our way to wipe off your child support. I'm gonna talk to Tiffany Chen and see if she can wipe off your child support. I say, no, brother, you gotta take care of your children. That is mandatory. Don't care about where the money is going for the mother. The mother is at home taking care of the children. If she needs to take the money to get her hair done, she is taking care of the children throughout the year. Way. It doesn't matter where the money is going, it just matters what you do and you are supposed to do. You have to develop that child. I understand. Information. So when I get the information from these guys that they are saying that I'm trying to, you know, figure out a way to get my arrears thrown out the door, to get my child support order minimized, I can read it. Because I've been around the population for so long, and they can't jive me. I know if you're going home to be a father or not, and if you're not, then I'm not going to expose you to a Tiffany Chen. It's like, Tiffany, you don't even need to talk to this guy right here, because we need to work with the individuals who are about doing something. We don't need to be wasting time with individuals who are still playing around. We need to be investing time to individuals who need the information, who are going to use the information. I'm not playing. I don't play with my time, and I'm not going to let anybody else play with it either. Just because a person is a father doesn't mean that they are trying to parent. And I understand that. I understand the reason behind the structure. I understand the reason behind the laws. I understand all of that. But what I am able to show guys is that if you come home and do what you are supposed to do, guess what? You will be able to live life at its highest quality. You won't have to worry about child support if you take care of your children, because the mother of your child will say, man, forget child support. We're going to go ahead and cancel the child support order. We're going to forgive the arrears because I trust you with the development of our son. We don't need child support. Because I know that you're not going to come up short. I know that you are going to do whatever it takes to be there to support our son. It starts within. It starts within yourself, and it starts within your current situation. The programs is mandatory. These men are coming home. They need the information. If the information is not given, then they will make the mistakes that I had made. And it ain't no more Fade 5 for T-Mobile. Obama phone, yeah. The Obama phone is only so many minutes, though. But that's reality. So I appreciate everybody in this room. I wrote the book, Prison Without Bars, to break a mentality, to let those guys know, to become the individual that you need to be today. Don't wait until tomorrow to try to become that individual. Prison Without Bars said that I was free while I was inside of prison, and therefore I've been able to maintain my freedom 8 years since I've been home now. That's the book, Prison Without Bars. is information that is needed for you guys too. Don't think that it's just for them. If you want to be able to impact your life, the life of others, you have to understand the mentality. My mentality is in that book. It'll help you get accomplished what you want to get accomplished. At the end of the day, just pay your child support. So we don't have to do all of this stuff, do all of the paperwork, just pay your child support. So we don't have to spend taxpayers' money locking you up. Just pay your child support. Good brother. I appreciate y'all, that's my time. Video, and this is a lot of what I was saying. This is the video. This is a slideshow of my life. And also, if you would like the book Prison Without Bars, it is $19.99. If you want to give me $20, I'll give you back a penny. I have the books up here today, so if you want a book, let me know, and I can get you that book. Okay? I go to the video.